Tēnā koutou katoa and welcome back to the Kazi.
No mai hoki mai ki Kazi.
E te rā nei talking to the man himself.
One of the fastest New Zealand creator TikTokers.
The OG mother frickin' Kazi, Uncle Tix. Kia ora bro, kei te pēha koe.
Kei te pai, brother pai ana, thank you.
No hea koe, Uncle Tix.
I am, hold on, me too. I'm in the mighty Kirikiriroa, Waikato.
Before we start.
Yeah, before we start this, we just want to ask you one question. Are we cuzzies?
Well, of course we're cuzzies. That's a stupid bloody question.
Yeah!
Stupid bloody question. That's what I would like to hear. Let's go. So we're just going to get into a couple of questions for you today. And do you want to start us off, Judah?
Sure. All right. Kay. So, Uncle, how did you come up with the name Uncle Tix?
Bit of a long story. Just let me put on my glasses.
Sorry, we don't have enough time for that.
just do the quick version of it. The quick version.
Uncle Tix came from my mates at Back Bar. I work in a local nightclub here in Hamilton. Oh, penis. And they pretty much just, because I've known them for bloody years, and the name just adapted over time. So they're like, oh, Uncle. And then it went to Uncle Tix. And I'm like, cool. And that's where the brand or the name came from.
Yeah.
Oh, choice.
And we've seen some of your videos, and we love watching your videos, bro. And wanted to talk to you about your flat. You live in a flat, right? And how many people live with you?
Heaps. It's a Whareanui. No, hold on. There's like six of us.
Oh, and so 10 though, eh?
Under 10, right?
Under 10 though, eh?
There is Jack, Uncle Jack, Uncle Jake, Alex, my partner, and myself. We have one other flatmate, but he's been away lately. So, yeah, so there's like six of us. It's a pretty big flat. Yeah.
So who's your favourite?
Yeah, who's your favourite?
Yeah.
Ooh. A bit of a juicy question.
Oh, probably my girlfriend.
Poor Uncle Jack.
Oh, who's the most annoying?
That is Alex, but she's also my favourite as well.
Santa Ellen. Yeah, and also for the viewers out there watching, can you tell them what Tourette's is? Like,
you have Tourette's. I've had a little bit of a, because I have to do this one all the time. So Tourette's is a neurological dysfunction in the brain. So it's pretty much something in your brain that's telling you to do stuff that you can't help. So like tics, like I'll jump around or call you a penis. Sorry, Nixon, you suck. Or I say stuff like that. And then it just pretty much flows and comes out. It's something that I can't help.
Yeah.
And it's just one of those things, you know?
Yeah.
What's the positives and the negatives about having Tourette's?
For you.
Positive is I can be as loud as I want and I can't really get in trouble because it's just me. I'm always loud. And the only, like, oh, that's the pro. The cons is, like, I stand up and, like, in the middle of a funeral and I'll laugh and I have to leave. Like, I just can't do it. I'm like, things like that. Just, like, I don't really care what people think about me and out when we're out, bloody, you know, if we were to go out and make TikToks and that. But at funerals or like serious things, like at a hui or similar, at a mihi, if I was at a mihi, I couldn't stand in there for very long. I'd probably yell something at one of the komatuas. So I have to leave. So that's the hardest thing.
Right. Yeah. That's the most difficult thing, I guess, as well. She says she wanna dance, but she don't know how to woo. Just do you enjoy like putting in Māori into your videos and showing that side of your culture to your audience?
Of course, bro. I like to put te reo into everything I do. It's a big part of me and who I am. So it was just when I first started first making my TikToks, I was like, you know, I started taking my culture more seriously. Years and years ago, I was super ignorant towards it, and I couldn't do this and I couldn't do that. And I was just like, super embarrassed about my Māori culture. But then as I grew up, I was like, what an absolute penis. What an absolute egg I am, you know?
Yeah,
I should have embraced it when I was a lot younger. And it wasn't until my old man passed away 2 or 3 years ago, and I was like, oh, I feel so ignorant. So that's where I fully took it on. And I'm being honest about it, you know? I'm super ignorant towards it, but
yeah.
I try and put as much Māori into my stuff as possible. As possible, because it's like, we should be proud of who we are.
Exactly. And like we were talking to Sunny the other day on a call, and he said that Māori opens up so much opportunities for us. And I can't, what was the thing he said?
I don't know. That was a very...
It was Te Reo Māori makes dreams come true. That's what his slogan was, I think. And we were saying like that, like, you know, also I think if I didn't make Māori content on my TikTok, I wouldn't be where I am today either.
Facts.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, I agree with that. It's characterized my alias as well. It's called an alias. And who I am. Like, you know, I tick on my Tourette's. I yell Māori Ora all the time. Like, you know, it's just me. And it's kind of adapted to who I am. So as much as, like, you know, it's pushing it out, it's also become my tick, which is amazing.
Yeah, and it also, like, I feel like whilst creating that Māori content brings an audience towards us that we wouldn't have before, mm-hmm. sort of thing. Like, because a lot of New Zealanders love that someone is doing that type of stuff and showing off New Zealand humour as well with Māori in it.
Yeah, like, I get a lot of my American friends that hit me up and go, bro, this is so Kiwi and I love it. Like, that's amazing. Like, people that are, you know, can relate now to us being like, oh, champ, bro, or stuff like that. You know, and the words that we say, they know that's Māori and they've learnt something off that. What does Māori Ora mean? You explain it to them. Oh, breath of life. Oh, that's amazing. I'll start saying it now. It's just like, fuck.
Yeah, because what's cool with you is you also get, like, a lot of views from around the world. And then that's also putting New Zealand on the map somewhat, or Māori on the map. And having that the Māori in it is just, like, 10 times better because not only are you showing New Zealanders that Māori's good, you're showing the world that we use that, like, all the time.
Yeah.
It's amazing. Really
the rangatahi, because, like, you know, I feel like... On TikTok, that's where they're both mostly placed, and just showing that Māori culture, I feel like they embrace it more, because we see it in our comments and see it in our lives as well. A lot of people are just commenting? I don't know. Anyway, like, kia ora and stuff, so it's like, it's choices. It's mean to see that.
I had a really cool thing last night. This guy I was live on Instagram. So I went live on Instagram for the first time in ages. And this guy from Minnesota jumped on and he greeted me with kia ora. And I was so blown away. I was like,
that's amazing.
Yeah. He's like, yeah, I just thought I'd greet you in that way because that's how you greet us. I'm like, oh, fucking, it made me cry. Gee, that's amazing. You know,
that means a lot to me.
I wouldn't usually say definitely. That, but, like, you know, I was just like, that's gay. I wouldn't usually. Oh, I was just like blown away. I was like, mate, that's amazing.
Yeah, that he goes out of his way to learn some of our culture and show it to you and greet you in that way is incredible.
That's what I like about that. That was cool.
How much Te Reo Māori do you know?
What percentage of Te Reo Māori do you know? Would you say?
I wouldn't know as much as you'd probably expect me to. Again, I wish I'd learned it at high school. I didn't. I learned French. I don't know why I did that. I don't know as much as I should, but my goal this year, next in the European, sorry mate, is to actually go and do a course and actually learn more.
Yeah, definitely. I feel like that's a goal.
I would say, like, a mid-tier course to try and get me through, and I'd love to be able to go to my pa, my marae, my whenua, and be able to talk to them fluently. But yeah. Oh, it's a big dream.
Yeah, I feel like that's definitely a goal for me and Judah, is to learn as much Māori as we can this year.
Why don't we do it all together?
Yeah, we could. We can
make mean TikToks about it.
Yeah, for sure.
That'd be cool.
A FaceTime call, Māori lesson. We could do it, like, right now on, like, maybe this Cuzzy's podcast. Learning Māori with Uncle Tix and Sunny Ngātai. He's got the 90% that he can teach us. I don't know if he's the best at anyway. Definitely. It's not Sunny Naito, Stan Walker's cousin. About that.
Stan Walker's cousin.
Yo.
Oh,
wow, my
God.
We lost technical difficulties.
Yeah, well, thanks for joining us, Uncle Tix. That was such a great show. And ka kite. Ka kite, my brother. And
later, our cousins.
Later, our my cousin. Is it the 40 minutes up, maybe?